Buddha reached at a mature age of 80, he was invited by a blacksmith named Kund or Chund, who belonged to Kasia village in Kushinagar. And Buddha reached there, he had accepted the invitation, reached there along with his cousin and prominent disciple Ananda. And Kund blacksmith offered to them shukar maddo, to eat, kind of dish. Jo bhi tha ye. Wo khaya Buddha ne, and he suffered from dysentery. And his body was left dehydrated. And he realized that he was not going to survive for more than 2 or 3 or 4 days. To unhone Anand se pucha, Anand se kaha ki Anand, ab meri death hone wali hai. To Anand bada udas hua aur usne pucha, thoda socha, fir pucha, what to do? Hey Tathagata, another name for Buddha. One who knows the truth is called Tathagata. So Ananda asked, oh Lord, what to do? What we are supposed to do with your bodily remains? So Buddha ne bola, pareshan mat ho, isme mat padho. Then, but press further, Buddha said, construct hemispherical domed shaped structure over the bodily remains or my relics. लोग वहां जाएंगे, फूल माला चढ़ाएंगे और उन्हें मन की शांति मिलेगी. सो स्तूपास वर बिल्ट ऑन द इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ द ग्रेट सोल महात्मा बुद्धा और लॉर्ड बुद्धा. सो द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ इरेक्टिंग स्तूपास मे हैव बीन प्री बुद्धिस्ट. बुद्धा के पहले भी स्तूप बनते थे, बट दे केम टू बी एसोसिएटेड विथ द बुद्धिज्म. सो स्तूपास came to be exclusively associated with the Buddhism and exclusively constructed for religious purpose, not for any other purpose, not serving any other purpose. And stupa, hemispherical dome-shaped structure, contains relics or bodily remains of Lord Buddha and his great disciples. Anand, Upali, Sariputra, Mahamodgalayan, Nand, and other disciples of Lord Buddha. So stupa contains relics regarded as sacred, and the entire stupa came to be venerated as the emblem, pratik chin, emblem or symbol of both the Buddha and the Buddhism. And according to Ashokavadan is a textbook of the Buddhism. Ashokavadan is a textbook of the Buddhism written in Sanskrit. Entitled Ashokavadan. So Ashokavadan describes the Buddhist activities of the great emperor Ashoka, and it states that from somewhere Ashoka got a portion of relics of Lord Buddha, and he had distributed those relics to every important city of his empire and ordered to construct stupas. So Ashoka is said to have constructed large number of stupas, thousands of stupas, but this number seems to be highly exaggerated. And how were stupas built? Like stupas were built not only by the rulers, not only by the kings or traders, but contributions made by the commoners and also the Buddhist monks and nuns called bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. So we find inscriptions or writings engraved on the pillars related to the stupas and panels, Vedika, railings. So inscriptions found on railings and pillars of a stupa record donations made for building and decorating them. Donations made not only by the kings, but also by the traders, by the commoners, and even Buddhist monks and nuns, they also made their valuable contribution in the construction of the stupas. To unke paas, bhikshu ke paas to paisa nahi hota, to shram daan karenge, labor. To, second point, some donations were made by the kings, ivory workers, haathi daant pe sajawat ka kaam karne wale karigar, ivory workers, and hundreds of men and women. And bhikkhus and bhikkhunis also made their valuable contribution towards building or erecting these monuments. And the structure of this stupa. Structure of this stupa. So, kya kya component ho gaya? Hemispherical dome shaped structure, anda. Top of the anda is a truncated flat structure surrounded by a boundary wall or a railing, and that structure is referred to as harmika, which means abode or mansion of the god. And exactly at the middle of the harmika, a stone yashti is placed, surmounted by chhatravali, three chhatravali, sapta chhatravali, or sometimes single chhatravali. And anda or a hemispherical dome shaped structure is regarded as considered as very, very sacred structure. So there was a natural desire to get the place separated from rest of the world. So inner railing was added. Vedika. Railing jod diya gaya taki duniyavi cheezon se is stupa ko alag kiya ja sake. And during subsequent ages, there was a natural desire to add outer main Vedika or जो बाउंड्री वॉल है, एंड अलोंग विद द बाउंड्री वॉल गेटवेज वर आल्सो एडेड एंड गेटवेज केम टू बी हाईली और प्रोफ्यूजली डेकोरेटेड. सो स्तूपा, ये हमने पढ़ा, कंटेंट मैंने डिस्कस किया. तो मैंने बताया आपको इन कोर्स ऑफ टाइम ड्यूरिंग द पोस्ट मॉडर्न पीरियड, नेचुरल डेवलपमेंट इन द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ स्तूपा वॉज द डिजायर to get the place separated from rest of the world or materialistic world. So there was a desire to enclose it on all the sides, and the enclosure was called Vedika. And during subsequent ages, toranas or gateways were also added, and toranas were profusely decorated with the engravings of animals, janvaron ki akritiyan, engravings of animals related to the life events of Buddha and Jataka stories or stories of previous births of Gautam Buddha, part of Sutta Pitaka of Tripitaka, collection of teachings of Lord Buddha. Sutta Pitaka ka part hai Jataka stories, and we'll be talking about literary content later on in our subsequent lectures in great detail. Okay, to Buddha ke life se jodi cheezon ko patthar pe ukera gaya, उन जानवरों के इमेजेस को उकेरा गया, बनवाया गया, हैविंग सम सिग्निफिकेंस, माइथोलॉजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस इन द बुद्धिज्म, लाइक लॉयन. लॉयन रिप्रेजेंट्स शाक्या ट्राइब ऑफ कपिलवस्तु, एंड लॉर्ड बुद्धा बिलोंग टू सिद्धार्थ गौतमा, और लॉर्ड बुद्धा बिलोंग टू शाक्या ट्राइब ऑफ कपिल वस्तु, एंड शाक्य इटसेल्फ मींस लॉयन. शाक्य मींस लॉयन. एंड एलिफेंट, engraving of elephant on the toranas along with lotus. Agar lotus ke saath elephant hai, to lotus and elephant represents birth of Siddharth Gautama. So in her dream, Mahamaya, mother of Siddharth Gautama, saw an elephant and herself bathing in a pond full of lotus. So lotus and elephant represent birth of Siddhartha, and elephant alone represents strength and wisdom. And bull in the Buddhist conception represent prosperity, and horse. So if you find image of a horse which represents great going forth, और महाभिनिष्क्रमण, घर छोड़ना, गृह त्याग. व्हेन सिद्धार्थ गौतम डिसाइडेड टू बी अ सन्यासी, व्हेन ही हैड रिनाउंस मेटलिस्टिक लाइफ ऑल टुगेदर, रिनाउंस मेटलिस्टिक लाइफ कंप्लीटली, कॉल्ड महाभिनिष्क्रमण. क्या ना, तो वो महाभिनिष्क्रमण घोड़ा, हॉर्स रिप्रेजेंट करता है. सो engravings of images of different animals having some mythological significance or relevancy, at least for the Buddhists. And Jataka stories are stories of previous births of Gautam Buddha. And see the Torana, image of a gateway of Sanchi Stupa, Torana. And Toranas came to be highly decorated or profusely decorated with the engravings of animals and Jataka stories having some significance in the Buddhist mythology or associated with the life events of Lord Buddha, like this one. So there, if there is the engraving of a tree, and that tree is not simply a tree. A tree in the Buddhist architecture and sculpture represents Bodhi tree or people ka ped, Ficus religiosa, which is its botanical name, and Siddhartha Gautama was enlightened under a peepal tree, which is now known as Bodhi tree, on the bank of river Niranjana at a place in Gaya district of Bihar called Bodh Gaya. Sam Bodhi, Gyan ki Prapti. Isilai wo jaga Bodh kehlata hai. Bodhi, Sam Bodhi, Gyan ki Prapti. So in this image, there are many people worshipping a tree or peepal tree representing enlightenment of Lord Buddha or enlightenment of Siddhartha Gautama. And once he came to be enlightened, he came to be known as Gautam Buddha. And there are other images as well, engravings as well, like elephants worshipping a stupa. And what does the stupa represent? Stupa represents death or Mahaparinibbana of Lord Buddha. A stupa itself represents death or Mahaparinibbana of Buddha and the Buddha himself. And there are some famous and important ancient stupas located at Sarnath, Bharhut, Amravati, and we were talking about Sanchi Stupa. So Sanchi, Sarnath, Bharhut, and Amravati are the good examples of ancient stupas. And there are three stupas at Sanchi. So remember this point, there are three stupas at Sanchi. Aur jo hum discuss kar rahe the, that was the stupa number one, which is the largest, the most decorated, and the most preserved among all the three stupas located at Sanchi. So there are three stupas. Sanchi stupa number one, number two, number three. Aur jo sabse shandar hai, wo stupa number one hai. So there are three stupas at Sanchi. And stupa number one, the largest and the most preserved one, the most beautiful one, has four beautifully engraved toranas or gateways. Four beautifully engraved toranas or gateways. And fourth one is not found at its original place of construction, and that has been preserved in a museum. So un pe engraving hai Buddha ki, unke life events ki, unse jude janwaron ki, ya fir previous stories of previous births of Lord Buddha. And Sanchi Stupa, which is located in Raisen district of Madhya Pradesh and is one of the oldest stone structure of our country, of India, and was originally commissioned by the great emperor Ashoka, who became a Buddhist. Earlier, Ashoka was a Shaivite, but after the Kalinga victory, when large number of people were left massacred, they were left butchered and killed, which caused much grief and remorse to the emperor Ashoka, and he left his original religion and he had decided to accept the Buddhism, so he became a Buddhist. And he is credited to have constructed thousands of stupa, or maine aapko bola, this number seems to be highly exaggerated, but this is true, that Ashoka got constructed many stupas, including Sanchi Stupa. And in the first century before Common Era, during the post-Mauryan period, four elaborately carved, extensively carved gateways or tornas were added. And a pillar, maine shuruaat nahi bataya tha aapko, a pillar, a finely polished sandstone was also added by, installed by the Emperor Ashoka, bearing image of four lions atop, sitting back to back and observing in all the four cardinal directions. And the original brick stupa, in the beginning when Ashoka got constructed Sanchi Stupa, it was a brick built structure. And during the post-modern period, stone encasing was done. Patthar chipkaye gaye post-modern period mein. Aur Ashoka ne jab banwaya tha, to ito ka bana hua tha. And stone encasing was done during the post-modern period, during the rulers of Shunga dynasty, like Pushyamitra Shunga, Agnimitra, and carving tarasha, murtiyan jo banayi gayi hain stupa pe, toranas pe, aur railings pe. Carving includes subject matters such as a lady named Sujata offering kshir or kheer to Buddha. Engraving of stories from Jatakas like Vesantara Jataka, Shibi Jataka and other such Jatakas. Shakra visit to Buddha, Bimbisara's visit, Stupa worship, elephants worshipping stupa, people worshipping people tree and images of Shalbhanjikas swinging at the corner of the Toranas. Shalbhanjikas are the divine creatures, divine women whose touch causing a tree to blossom and to bear fruits. तो शालभंजिका स्त्रियां ऐसी स्त्रियां हैं डिवाइन जो किसी पेड़ को छू दें तो उसमें फ्लावरिंग हो जाती है और उसमें फल लग जाते हैं, विच मींस पॉसिबली द गॉडेस ऑफ फर्टिलिटी शालभंजिकास. एंड धमेख स्तूपा इज अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट स्तूपा लोकेटेड एट सारनाथ इन वाराणसी. एंड अपोजिट टू दैट ऑफ सांची स्तूपा, धमेख स्तूपा इज नॉट अ हेमिस्फेरिकल डोम शेप स्ट्रक्चर, इट्स cylindrical in its shape and nothing but that cylindrical shape aur kuch bhi nahi hai. Neither the harmika nor yashti or kshatravali or nor inner railing, outer railing, stairway, kuch bhi nahi hai. Sirf aur sirf anda hai which is not a hemisphere, is cylindrical in its typical shape, reaching the height of 44 meter. So it's a massive brick built structure and stone encasing at its lower part. So Dhamek Stupa is a massive stupa located, see the literature, the content, Dhamek Stupa is a massive stupa located at Sarnath in Varanasi. Originally built during the 5th century before common era, 2500 साल पुराना है, अशोक के भी पहले का था. तो अशोक ने क्या किया, एनलार्जमेंट करवाया. ठीक है, सो ओरिजिनली बिल्ट ड्यूरिंग द 5th सेंचुरी बिफोर कॉमन एरा, सो परहैप्स दिस स्तूपा वॉज कंटेम्पररी टू बुद्धा, उनके जमाने का स्तूप है. एंड एनलार्ज बाई अशोका इन द ईयर पॉसिबली 249 बिफोर कॉमन एरा टू कॉमेमोरेट, यादगार स्मृति के लिए, टू कॉमेमोरेट द बुद्धिस्ट एक्टिविटीज इन दिस रीजन, बिकॉज इट वॉज हियर एट सारनाथ दैट लॉर्ड बुद्धा डिलीवर्ड हिज फर्स्ट सर्मन टू हिज फर्स्ट फाइव डिसाइपल्स, नेमली कौंडिन्या, भद्दीय, तात्ते, महानाम एंड अश्वजीत. तो यादगार के तौर पर पहला उपदेश, फर्स्ट सर्मन ऑफ लॉर्ड बुद्धा, विच इज रिफर्ड टू एज द इवेंट इज रिफर्ड टू एज सेट इन मोशन और टर्निंग द व्हील ऑफ रिलीजन, धर्म का पहिया घुमा देना, बुद्धिज्म की शुरुआत होना, कॉल्ड धम्मा चक्रा प्रवर्तन और सेट इन मोशन द व्हील ऑफ लॉ, द व्हील ऑफ रिलीजन. एंड लेटर ऑन स्तूपा वॉज एनलार्ज, धमेक स्तूपा वॉज एनलार्ज एट 6 ऑकेजन. And but we don't know why the upper part had always remained unfinished, and also we don't know why they had not added inner railing, outer railing or gateways or harmika, kuch bhi nahi add on kiya, to hum nahi jante aisa kyun hua. And in its current shape the Dhamek Stupa is a solid cylinder of bricks and stone reaching the height of around 44 meters, Kutub Minar 72.5 meter. एंड स्टोन फेसिंग, जो नीचे पत्थर लगाया गया है, स्टोन फेसिंग के निचले हिस्से में पत्थर लगा हुआ है. स्टोन इनकेसिंग बियर्स फ्लोरल डिजाइंस एंड अ राइटिंग इन ब्राह्मी स्क्रिप्ट, एंड द स्टाइल ऑफ राइटिंग एंड फ्लोरल डिजाइन बिलोंग टू द गुप्ता पीरियड, 1500-1600 साल पहले जो नॉर्थ इंडिया में गुप्ता डायनेस्टी था उस जमाने का वो फ्लोरल डिजाइन और ज्योमेट्रिकल डिजाइन है. एंड there is another very important stupa, not less important than the Sanchi stupa itself. And this stupa located at Amravati is referred to as Mahastupa because this stupa was originally constructed over the bodily remains or relics of Lord Buddha himself. Unke sharirik avsesho pe banaya gaya. So Amravati stupa. And this Amravati stupa, see this image, is a ruined stupa, khandhar stupa, and nothing but its foundation remains at its original place of installation. So this Sharirika type of stupa is of great importance, not only for the Buddhists, but also all of us for this world because Lord Buddha delivered or gave a message of peace and non-violence to this world. And this is the, this image is the replica, nakal hai, replica. Okay? और जब ये रहा होगा तो बहुत ही खूबसूरत स्तूप आ रहा होगा. तो इसमें खास बात ये देखिए कि इट्स आंडा इज ऑल्सो फुल्ली डेकोरेटेड एंड डेकोरेटेड विथ फ्लोरल एंड ज्योमेट्रिकल डिजाइंस. एंड देर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ दिस अमरावती स्तूपा. तो यहां पे देखिएगा आप स्क्रीन पे, ये जो प्रोजेक्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म है ना, ये ऐसे प्लेटफॉर्म निकला हुआ है, प्रोजेक्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म इन ऑल द डायरेक्शंस, प्रोजेक्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म कॉल्ड, दीज आर फोर है, देर आर फोर प्रोजेक्टिंग रेक्टेंगुलर प्लेटफॉर्म्स कॉल्ड आयक, आयका प्लेटफॉर्म्स, आयका प्लेटफॉर्म्स. और उन आयका प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे ओरिजिनली 5 पिलर्स लगे हुए थे. एवरी आयका प्लेटफॉर्म इन ऑल दी 4 डायरेक्शन कंटेन, ओरिजिनली कंटेन 5 पिलर्स. एंड दोस पिलर्स आर नाउ प्रिजर्व इन डिफरेंट म्यूजियम्स. एंड 5 पिलर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग 5 डिफरेंट इवेंट्स ऑफ बुद्धास लाइफ. 5 पिलर्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग 5 डिफरेंट इवेंट्स ऑफ बुद्धास लाइफ. फर्स्ट पिलर रिप्रेजेंट्स बर्थ ऑफ सिद्धार्थ गौतमा. सेकेंड पिलर रिप्रेजेंट्स ग्रेट गोइंग फोर्थ और रिनंसिएशन, गृह त्याग. एंड थर्ड पिलर रिप्रेजेंट्स हिज एनलाइटमेंट एट बोध गया अंडर अ पीपल ट्री, एनलाइटमेंट सम बोधि. एंड फोर्थ पिलर रिप्रेजेंट हिज धम्मा चक्रा प्रवर्तन इवेंट और हिज फर्स्ट सर्मन ही हैड डिलीवर्ड एट सारनाथ इन वाराणसी टू हिज फर्स्ट 5 डिसाइपल्स कौंडिन्य भद्दीय तात्य महानाम एंड अश्वजीत. एंड फिफ्थ पिलर रिप्रेजेंट्स हिज डेथ, डेथ ऑफ अ ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कॉल्ड महाभिनिष्क्रमण, महाभिनिष्क्रमण. सो देयर आर 5 आयका पिलर्स representing 5 events of Buddha's life. Say this. So the literature, the content, a ruined Buddhist stupa in Andhra region. And it's a brick-built structure, ito ka bana hua, circular Vedika, raha hoga originally, ab nahi hai. With projecting, this one is important, projecting rectangular Aika platforms in all the directions. In all the directions. And 5 Aika pillars represents the 5 main events of Buddha's life. His birth, ghar chhodna, grihatyag, renunciation or great going forth, mahabhi, nishkraman. Third pillar, his enlightenment at Bodh Gaya. Fourth pillar, dhamma chakra pravartan or first sermon of Buddha at Sarnath. And fifth pillar represents mahaparinibbana or death. And Amravati stupa is a Sharirika type of a stupa constructed over the bodily remains of Buddha, and hence it's of great importance. Yadgar ke taur pe nahi bana hua hai, directly Buddha ke Sharirik avshesh pe bana hua hai. And the foundation of this Maha stupa was laid by the Emperor Ashoka around 2300 years back, 3rd century before Common Era. And now, most of the components of this stupa are preserved in the British Museum, Kolkata and Chennai Museum. So, Angrej bahut sare iske parts utha ke le gaye the, tang le gaye the us zamane mein, jab isko discover kiya gaya tha. Okay. And there is another ruined stupa, Khandar stupa, located at Bharut in central India. And this Bharut stupa may have been first built by the great emperor Ashoka, but many works of art, sajavat, tarashna, murtiya banana, many works of art were apparently added during the post-modern period, during the Shunga period, by a person named Vashishthiputra Dhanabhuti. And the ruined stupa, nothing but foundation of the main structure, is still in Bharat, but gateways and railings, toranas and vedikas are preserved in Kolkata Museum.